Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us continue the selection sort, guys. So we have discussed about selection sort in the last lecture, right? So how it works and everything. So in this lecture, let us write the algorithm and trace the algorithm with a problem. Okay, so selection sort of a comma n for of k 1 to n minus 1. So first element to last element minus 1. Okay, so minimum is equal minimum a of k. Minimum, the first element is considered as a of k. So location is nothing but k. So you'll be considering, when there are no sorted elements, you'll be considering the first element as to be sorted. So basically you'll be finding the minimum and pushing it into the here, and you'll be considering this as the sorted, and later on you'll be continuing like that slowly, step by step. So that is the reason why k is the location for j is equals to k plus 1. So the next terms only you should check, you should not check from first again. To n, if a minimum is greater than a of j, sorry for that, if minimum is greater than a of j, then minimum is equals to a of j. So you'll be storing the value of minimum in a of j, because a of j is minimum, and you will be storing that location also, and you'll be continuing this process. So you'll be continuing until you find the smallest element, and at the end you'll be swapping the smallest element with its original position. That's it. So basically this is the algorithm. So basically you can say that in quicksort we took a random element and we took it into its position. But here in selection sort, you will be selecting the minimum or the maximum and putting it into its place. That's it. Okay? Okay. So let us take a small example. I hope algorithm is clear, guys, because this is a common format algorithm which we will be writing for any kind of explanations. So let us take an array 8, 2, 9, 1, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 element array in the first iteration. So we will be following 5 iterations, right? So in the first iteration, we will be having, sorry, we will be considering 4 iterations, n minus 1, right? So 4 iterations. So 8, 2, 9, 1, 4. So initially, you will be starting minimum as 8. You'll be comparing with 2. You'll be saying minimum is 2. And after that, 2 with 9, no change. 2 with 1, there is a change, 1. And the location will be swapped till 4. Like where the location indicates that where the exact element is. And you will be swapping it with k. They will be swapped. So the result will be 1, 2, 9, 8, 4. Okay. So similarly, if you continue, you'll be getting 1, 2, 9, 8, 4. The second element is already in its position, but you'll be checking it, guys. I think I forgot to write about the explanation. So you'll be checking again and again. Okay. And there is no chance for this to move anywhere. So you'll be writing it there only. Similarly for 9. 9 and 8, the minimum will be 8. So initially you'll be assuming 9 as the minimum and the 3 as the position. And this will become 8, 4. At the end, it becomes 4 and 9. So 9 will be, sorry, 5. And fifth element, that is nothing but 4, will be swapped with the first element. That is nothing but 9. So you'll be getting in this way. So in this way, the selection sort works, guys. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So selection sort is nothing but a simple sorting algorithm, where you will be selecting the smallest element, putting it in the first. Second smallest, second place. Third smallest, third place. Fourth smallest, fourth place. Fifth smallest is already in its place. That's it. So that is how the quicksort algorithm works. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through. So till now, we are done with sorting, guys. So basically, we are done with sorting the main algorithms we have discussed. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through Stresemann's matrix multiplication. So we already know how matrix multiplication is done. So how does a computer does? And it was given that an efficient way to do matrix multiplication by Stresemann. So we'll be discussing about that in the next lecture. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.